I don't know what to do. Like, I don't know what
so
to
you just
do.
Okay, let me tell you what to do.
All right.
So you just sit there and you sit there relaxed. Maybe
do
like.
Do I look at you? Who do I look
no,
at?
No, you just look at the where you're supposed okay. to be looking. Right. Like pretend look. Like Walker's just like right there.
We have a multiple mentor model at Stanford. So I always recommend to students, talk to a number of different people. Talk to faculty, staff, peers, more advanced students. Get as much information as you can. Ultimately, you're gonna be making the best decision for yourself, but it's helpful to hear different perspectives.
My name is Raymond Chen.
Oh, I'm Shannon Reeder.
My name is Carrie Wakefield.
I'm Lauren Reed. I am also an ARC advisor with Shannon.
My graduate work was in molecular and cell biology.
My PhD is in English, but in particular, it's in literature and technology, which is to say science fiction.
My PhD is in higher education.
I attended Gonzaga University, which is up in Spokane, Washington, and I was, you can't tell right now, but I'm pretty tall, and so I was a women's basketball player.
And I went to UC Riverside, and I was a track and field athlete. I was a jumper. As ARC advisors, we're assigned to specific sports, so we work very closely with youth over the next 4 years and help you navigate your academic experience here at Stanford.
I'm one of 12 advisors that are based in the residence halls, which means our offices are right there. Students can roll right out of their dorms, come into our office, and talk to us about all sorts of things.
Well, good advising is a variety of things based on the circumstance. And so sometimes good advising is just helping a student figure out exactly how to navigate university bureaucracy. How do I enroll in a class? How do I drop a class? How do I do X, Y, or Z?
So we work very closely with youth over the next 4 years and help you navigate your academic experience here at Stanford. That entails the tutorial services available, advising when you decide what you want to major in, and even before that when you're just planning your schedule quarter to quarter.
Finding research opportunities and service opportunities, connecting with faculty. My job is really to make sure that students are maximizing their time at Stanford. So part of that is finding their academic home, but another piece of that is just really navigating, you know, policies, procedures. This is, it's a big place and there's a lot to learn and a lot of resources.
Good advising, it's help that encourages somebody to grow and develop, to be reflective, to be comfortable with the limits of their current knowledge and to seek resources and opinions from other people, and then to be comfortable taking responsibility for synthesizing that information and making their own choices.
So I always recommend to students, talk to a number of different people. Talk to faculty, staff, peers, more advanced students. Get as much information as you can. Ultimately, you're going to be making the best decision for yourself, but it's helpful to hear different perspectives.
As an academic advising director, it's my responsibility to know how this university in particular works. What are the ins and outs? What are the rules? What are the regulations? And what are the options you have in terms of curriculum? That is not what your pre-major advisor does. They are not necessarily an expert in Stanford rule and regulations, but they are an expert in universities. They know what a university culture is like. They've had their own experience as a college student. And they can also help connect you with other people here on campus.
My name's Bob Lindblom.
My name is Kathy Hawes.
My name's Hillary McKinney.
I'm John Fox.
I'm Buchev Keskin-Kosat.
I am Marcelo Gleditriarias.
My name's Kenny Ligda.
My career was with Chevron.
And I have roles on campus and at Slack.
And I teach economics. I've been teaching economics for over 20 years.
I'm Associate Director, Instructional Design at the Vice Provost for Teaching and Learning.
I'm a lecturer here at Stanford, and I work at the Language Center.
Associate Director of University Corporate and Foundation Relations.
And I'm an Associate Director in Major Gifts in the Office of Development, and I'm also a PMA.
What I try to do to help students when I'm advising is, above all, just be someone that they can talk to.
And I always try to be available when they want to talk about things or concerns.
I try to be a connector. So if someone has a question, I'll try to connect them with someone who I think on campus knows about that area that they're interested in. And I think, too, it's important just to talk about how students are acclimating to campus, how their dorm is, how life is on campus.
I try and listen carefully, and I try to offer ideas, and I try and help people make this transition to college in a very successful way.
I think I help them to become Stanford citizens, and I also try to challenge them and try to help them discover their passions, meaning their majors, minors, but also their interest in in liberal education at large.
As a PMA, I think it's so important to assist students because some may be concerned, and I think it's so important to be able to sit with them one-on-one.
And connecting them also with folks on and off campus, I think it's very important to for them not to rely just on me, but also get to know different people, not only because they know more about certain disciplines or ways of life, but also because then they will have a deeper and broader network to rely upon at Stanford.
The advice I would give my younger undergraduate self is
explore.
Get out and out past campus a little bit more.
Go meet more people, meet the faculty.
Really get out there.
You are the author of your life. Like, you get to decide what you want to major in. You get to decide what kind of career you have.
I think keeping an open mind is the advice I would give myself as a college student.
And I mean, explore academically, explore different kinds of classes that you didn't necessarily expect to take when you're here on campus.
Perhaps they didn't use as much faculty office hours, for example.
At the end of the day, you need to be happy with your own decisions. So even if you are thinking about a major that's not that popular on campus, or maybe going a different direction than your parents went professionally, that's okay. Like, be true to yourself, follow your passions. There's not a right answer. As long as you keep sort of listening to that inner voice, it's going to steer you well.
Recognize there's a big value in experience. And just because you think you're going to do everything yourself your own way doesn't mean you can't benefit from hearing other people's ideas. You may well reject these ideas or reject this advice, but it's probably a good idea to hear it, and you might be surprised to think about it and realize there's a grain of value in it.